before I even started to think about painting the wall, I had to clear everything out because there was just so much crap in there that I didn't want in there. So I took out the chair, I took out all the junk in there that I had had from like a few months ago when I was in there. And then I painted the desk white to give it a more minimal look. So I wanted to just clean it up a little bit before I actually started the painting. So for the paint for the mural, I ended up just using sample sizes from Home Depot. This is the Bare Ultra brand, and I didn't actually run out of any of them, which kind of surprised me, but they all lasted. This is the maple glaze color, this one is terracotta clay, this one is cactus bloom, and then the last one is prairie rose, but I also got a black, so it ended up costing me like $25 for the whole project, which isn't too bad. So I highly recommend using sample sizes if you're not painting like something huge. This was my first ever wall mural, but I figured I really couldn't screw it up too bad considering I'm just painting abstract shapes on the wall. So I did actually paint something that I regretted later on in the video, and you'll see how I fixed it super easily. So I just used a regular paintbrush for the wall and then cleaned up the edges with a smaller paintbrush. Also, just wanted to add in there that I highly recommend drawing out your wall mural if you are going to do this, just so you have a basic idea of what you want it to look like before you actually do it. It'll save a lot of time later. I just used Procreate, but you can obviously just use a piece of paper. So this is where things go a little wrong. I decided to paint the leaf in the top right corner, but after I had painted two whole coats, which is even worse, I decided I didn't like it. So I turned the leaf into an abstract shape at the top right and then sanded down where it overlapped onto the orange shape. I wanted the orange shape to look like it was overlapping the pink one, if that makes sense. So I sanded it down and I painted over it like two coats, and it ended up turning out pretty good. You can still see a little bit of the like indents of the leaf, but I fixed it. It was fine. It wasn't that serious, but just a lot of extra work since I decided I didn't like it. Thank you. It probably wouldn't be a full studio tour without me telling you where everything is from, so I'm gonna do my best to show you everything. We'll start with these shelves. We actually made these shelves using just cinder blocks and wood. We just stacked them on top of each other. It was really cheap and super easy. This lamp is from Hobby Lobby. I don't know if they still have it because I got it a while ago. These are my little plants that I potted, and I painted the pots with acrylic paint. It was really simple, but it gave them a lot of character, so if you want to spruce up your plants, just paint them. Not the plants, the pots. It was really easy. This is my Fujifilm Polaroid camera. I don't know exactly how to say it, but I got it on eBay, and it's probably a really old version of it, but it looks cute anyway. Next on the shelf, I have a print that I made. If you didn't know, I sell my prints. Well, I'm currently under construction, but I will start selling them again soon. But I just framed it with a Marshall's frame. And then I have that little basket to the right, and that is from the thrift store. Most of my baskets and vases and jars are thrifted because they're super cheap and really cute and vintage looking. And then I have a bunch of books. Next thing I have is this little planter from Michael's. It's actually from the gardening collection right now that's 50% off, I think. So I got it for like probably $6, and it's really cute. I just planted three little succulents in there, and I think it turned out pretty stinking cute. It makes it look like I gave it a lot of effort when I really truly didn't. Why is my finger over there? I'm a horrible filmer. Oh my gosh. Next plant in line. There's a lot of plants on the shelf, so hopefully I don't bore you with it, but this plant is, I think it's a snake plant, but the box that I planted it in or potted it in is from the thrift store. It leaks a little when I water it, but it's okay. It looks kind of cute, so I like it. Like I said, I have a bunch of books from the thrift store for my Patreon, and then I have a little jar that I got from the thrift store, painted it white, and put some eucalyptus in it. Fun fact, the eucalyptus sprig is from my wedding bouquet, so I can look at it with happiness and joy. This watering can is from the antique store. I found it and it was a good steal for $10, and I had to have it, but I'm sure you can get them anywhere. This one's just vintage, so of course I had to have it. Next, I have some more flowers. Well, I guess that's the first flowers that I actually showed, but they are from Roxanne's Dried Flowers on Instagram, and she has really good grasses, flowers, etc. I just said etc. The basket is from the thrift store, and then the deer head is something my husband found on the side of the road, and he insisted that I put it in my studio, so I did. And it's kind of cute. I have more books and another print that I made, along with the little jar with the flowers in them. The jar is from the Target dollar spot. So moving on, in that window right there that I briefly showed, we're putting the AC unit as soon as it comes. And then I got this wicker shelf from an antique store for $10. On the top of the shelf, there is a pink little jar with some baby's breath in it. I painted the jar with acrylic paint and it turned out really cute. And then the other jar, I just put in dried flowers that had fallen off the branch. What else? So let's just ignore this finger in the top left corner that I can't get over. I can't believe that I didn't notice that until now. But the glass house is from the Michael's Garden Collection. Again, it was 50% off and it was pretty recent, so maybe you can still snag it. The wheat is from Michael's too, I think. And then both the candles are just random candles, I don't know. And behind that, I just have two prints from the antique store, along with this Dream Children book. Look how cute it is. It's so tiny. I got it from the antique store too. So you already saw it, but this is the final result of the wall mural. My final thoughts are I love it. I think it turned out exactly as I pictured. I was a little worried there for a minute because I messed up a few times, but we pushed through and it was pretty easy to complete, really, in the grand scheme of things. So if you want to do this, I highly encourage you to do it. The table in the corner is from Marshall's, and then the rug is actually an outdoor rug from Target. I just got it on sale for $128, and it's a 7x10, which is pretty good, but we did have flooding, so I decided to get an outdoor rug just in case it flooded again. Hopefully it won't. These propagation bulbs are from Amazon, and they come with all like the hardware to hang them. And I'll link them below, but I'm propagating some plants and hoping that they turn into bigger plants. Next is the desk area. There's a bunch of stuff to show you and tell you where I got it from, but I will focus on the lamp first. So the floor lamp is from Amazon. I think it was $40. Again, I'm linking everything below. It's pretty good. I really like how bright it is, and you can also move it. It was hard to show with one hand, but you can adjust the angle of it, which is really nice, especially for artwork. On my desk, I have my typewriter, and I'm so proud of it because I just got it on Lego, and it was a steal. It was only $10, and it works perfectly. Funny story, I just got it the other day, and when I got home, I was so excited to show Spencer that I was running with it in the driveway on the concrete, and I dropped it face down, and it was tragic. I was just sitting with it in the driveway, but we fixed it. Only the shift key broke off, so it was fine, but it was just kind of tragic, but also pretty funny. But yeah, it does work and it's very cute. So on my mini shelves, I have my watercolors. I have everything labeled, but some of it actually isn't very accurate because on the top shelf I have one called Sharpies and it's like colored pens, but it's okay, it looks organized regardless. I also have my foam memo printer. It's a thermal printer up top that I use for my journal, and a little plant from Home Depot. And then these are my main pens. I have just a bunch of stuff that I use like on the daily, so I keep them in there. And I have some wax seals and my watercolor set, along with all of my paintbrushes behind the pens jar right there. Moving on to my pegboard, from right to left, I have some rulers that are different sizes. I have two pairs of scissors, some masking tape, and then I have some of my paints out. So the baskets are from the Dollar Tree. We just bent them so that they would fit. They're not actually meant for a pegboard. I'm sure there are ones out there that are actually meant for that, but we just rigged it a little bit. So those are $2. And then I also have a circle stencil and a little palette for paint mixing that I actually do use. It's not blank, but I turn it around because I like a more clean look. But that is what it looks like on the back. By the way, I'm not mentioning where I get all my supplies from in this video because I've already done a video for that. I'll put a card above. But on the desk, I have a jar of stamps and some other stuff I use on a daily basis. And then I have another candle. I have these candlesticks from an antique store. I'm obsessed with them right now. And some taper candles, obviously. And then I have this box from the thrift store that I hold all my other acrylic paints in, and just some random washi tapes that are too bright for my liking to be actually out on display. I also have these dried palm leaves in a jar from the thrift store. The palm leaves are from Roxanne's Dried Flowers as well. I also have a reed diffuser on the desk that is from Target. It looks really cute. I don't know if it actually smells great. I just put it in there. I have this printable calendar from Jasmine Dowling. She has really beautiful designs, so I put it on a clipboard and hung it on the wall. I haven't actually filled it out yet, but I plan to. It's just not May yet. Next to the reed diffuser, I have my bowl of washi tapes. The bowl is from the thrift store, and the washi tapes are from DH Gate. Y'all, I don't even know what to say about this finger in the corner anymore. This is the only footage I got, so we're just gonna have to handle it for a second. The coasters are from the antique store, and they are a steal. They're so cute and just so dainty. I also have an actual diffuser on my desk, and I was diffusing some clove oil because it is my favorite. On the end of the desk, I have my printer. It's a Brother printer, and I don't know exactly which one it is, but I'll put it in the description in case you're interested. I put a bunch of just random stuff under the desk. So I have some cords, obviously, and then my backpack and a tripod and a trash can. And I got this storage bin thing from Amazon, and I think it was like $40. And it was so worth it because I had a bunch of ugly supplies and crap that I didn't want out, but I didn't have a place for it. So it was the perfect buy. And I just put my journal and some books on top of it. In the top drawer, I put all those ugly supplies that I wouldn't want to set out. And so I use those pretty often in my journal. And then I also have my box of scraps. That's my iPad on top. But in that Fabletics box, I have all my scraps and pictures that I cut out of magazines. In the third drawer, I have a bunch of crap in there. It's all like the paint that I used for the wall mural. And then in the last drawer, I just have some cords and my tripod stuff. And yeah, so that is where all the junk goes. Moving on to my collage wall, a lot of people ask me where I got the pictures and papers from. And I know you're probably sick of hearing me say it, but they are from antique and thrifted books. Some are antique postcards. I have a whole video on my journaling Q&A video where I talk about how to find those things. So go and check that out if you are interested. Also wanted to say the three hanging bulbs are from Amazon. This mirror is from At Home and I got it in November, so who knows, it was on sale, it's probably not there anymore, but I think it adds some character. That is it for the tour. I really appreciate you watching and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.